because they are organic, that enables some fabrication methods that are not possible with many other choices of active layer. So the advantage of the polymer solar cell is the ultra fast manufacture that is possible. So even though they are less performing compared to silicon by a factor of 4 in terms of area in practical technological exhibits, the manufacturing speed is far, far, far faster. So you could say, even though you need 4 times more area, it doesn't matter because you are 1,000 times faster. Where it's different is that the active material, so the material that actually does the conversion, so absorbs the sunlight or the light and converts it into an electrical current, that is a polymer or an organic molecule. A consequence of having an organic active layer that can be manufactured, disposed as a solar cell in a particular way, also takes with it a lot of other things that are impossible for some technologies, things such as very low embodied energy, very fast manufacture, very thin outline, very high absorption cross sections possible, very, in principle, benign environmental impact, both in the making, in the use phase, and also in the disposal phase. The obvious question is, why isn't it here then? If it's so fantastic, why isn't it here? And that is, I suppose, the case with all the fantastic science that you read about in the newspapers, is you hear about all these fantastic implications, perspectives, and then even after a significant while, it still isn't there. And the answer to why isn't it here then, when it's so fantastic, is, I suppose, is a general disease that all new technology is inflicted with, that you often over-focus on the advantages and not the disadvantages. So let's look at the disadvantages here instead. It has been very difficult to increase the power conversion efficiency. So basically the efficiency with which they convert sunlight into useful electrical energy. They started around 1990 with presenting meaningful efficiencies of the order of a percent. Today, at least record efficiencies of up to 12 for the organic technology has been demonstrated. You take a panel of silicon solar cell and you take a panel of polymer solar cell, then the area correspondence is about a factor of 3 to 4. So you need a 4 times larger panel of polymer solar cell to produce, say, 100 watts of power compared to a silicon solar cell panel. Another disadvantage is the stability. In terms of when you shine light at organic molecules, they tend to react with oxygen and water, and therefore they break down. And that is another example of a disadvantage that can in part be overcome by packaging and also design of the materials. But outdoor stabilities, at least on the northern latitudes, have been demonstrated for many, many years, for 4 to 5 years already. And while it is unlikely maybe that with today's technology that 25 years is reached, 25 years is commonly reached with silicon, the organic solar cell certainly has the potential to easily reach the 10 years by today's standards. Yeah, so turning to the advantages, it's a much easier task because they are so obvious. Because they are organic, that enables some fabrication methods that are not possible with many other choices of active layer. Way the polymer solar cell is made is printing. You print it. So not only can you make it exceptionally fast through the method of printing, but you also only, in principle at least, you print the material where you want it. So it's additive. You don't waste material in the process of manufacture. So it is an additive and ultra fast manufacturing method, and this is simply unsurpassed. No other solar cell technology does this. Now, a solar cell is a multi-layer structure, and fortunately the printing approach that the polymer solar cell is so amenable to is inherently allows for making a printing machine, a setup that consecutively prints all the layers in the stack. So you have a machine where you put in raw material, and at the end you have a completed solar cell that comes out at the same line speed. So it can be made horrendously fast. Also in terms of the width that you process in, that's of course a free way of increase the throughput to just print wider. This has also been demonstrated and in significant width. So you could say, even though you need four times more area, it doesn't matter because you are 1,000 times faster easily. Then there is the amount of material you use. You also use a lot less material in the process. So even though you need four times larger area, you still use a lot less material. So you're accomplishing with a thickness of 1 micron what silicon needs at least 100 to do. So you're still up by a factor of 25 in terms of, you could say, bulk materials use. It's much less energy requiring in both the embodiment of energy in the materials themselves and also in the process. They're not toxic. They are at least in some forms, and they are easily disposed environmentally. They have much less impact. They can be installed really fast. So you could say, even though you need four times larger area, it has been demonstrated that you can still install a certain energy producing capacity much, much faster than you can with, for instance, with all other known technologies, because you can explore the flexibility, basically roll it out. So you can roll it out very fast. And therefore, even though it's less efficient in terms of area performance, it's, you can roll it out much faster. In terms of manufacturing speed, manufacturing scale, materials consumption, all these aspects are easily answered by the polymer solar cell technology. The challenge, if I should mention one, is that you need this larger area. Like for solar, you need significant land mass. And this in many ways is the largest challenge of how to implement solar technology in our gradually becoming renewable society. So it's about exploring roofs, facades, building integration, maybe on water, solar parks, all that we are starting to see emerge. So not only erecting large solar parks in areas where you potentially at least could do something more useful with the land, and instead maybe explore areas where we aren't doing much with the land anyway. Yeah, so the polymer solar cell is now at a very interesting moment in time where it's been proven that the manufacturing speed, the cost, the environmental impact can be realized to its potential. And therefore, we are now seeing that this is being explored and it is entering the market. There are several independent efforts on bringing the polymer solar cell to market, and the uptake or the absorption into the market, how well it will fare in this market, is of course will be determined by how well we solve or address the disadvantages that it has been challenged with. I mean, we've come a long way with those, and I'm convinced that these will be overcome, but how well they will be overcome will determine how big it will become.